Welcome back, children, to our next class in science. Hope all of you are fine and safe. Hope all of you are good. Keep safe, be good. So children, today our chapter is something on a very important topic. Yes, about electricity. Electricity is a form of energy that has been dominating in our lives since the last few years. You know, before in the olden days and all, electricity was not there in many of the houses. But now, the full day, even it looks like it's lighted up. The full day is lighted up. Even at night, you have got a lot of electricity and light all around you. And the concept of darkness or the concept of night is vanishing gradually. But then we should know what are the effects of this electricity. So in this chapter, we are going to study about the chemical effects of electric current. So before going into the chapter, you might be remembering something. You must be remembering something that you have learned on the topic in your previous classes. You have learned about the substances that are able to conduct electricity, and there are some other substances that are not able to conduct electricity. Those that are able to conduct electric current, they are called conductors. And those that are not able to conduct electric current, they are called insulators or they are called non-conductors. So come on, let us go and watch our chapter, modules on our chapter, Chemical Effects of Electric Current. So our chapter for today is the Chemical Effects of Electric Current. Now you know that substances which allow electric current to pass through them are called conductors, like aluminium, steel, copper. Substances that do not allow electric current to pass through them are called insulators, or they are called non-conductors. Now, we have a question in our mind. Do liquids conduct electricity? Come, let us study about that. Do liquids conduct electricity? We have to know them through some activities. But before that, you have already studied in your lower classes how to make a tester. In the tester here, that is shown here, we have used a tester to prepare one. But for this class, that means for 8th standard, we'll make a tester by using a battery. As you can see, wires connected to the battery and there is a bulb at the other end. Now the question is, do liquids conduct electricity? Look at the activity. Activity 1. Join the free ends of a tester so as to complete the circuit. The circuit is consisting of the tester, the battery, and the bulb. If you observe the bulb glowing, that means the tester, that means electricity is passing through the wires. Correct? If the electricity is passing, that means the bulb will glow. But if the bulb is glows, that means the tester is ready to use. But if the bulb is not glowing, then there could be many reasons. Either loose connections might be there, the bulb is not working because it might have got fused, or the battery could be discharged, that means the battery is not having any charge, or maybe the wires that are connected in the circuit, they are not working. So we have to check all that and then we have to conduct the activity. So that was your first activity. This you all might be able to do it at home also, taking a cell. Previously, you were using a cell, but now we use a battery for our experiments. Battery, one tester, and bulb connecting wires, and if the bulb burns, that means the circuit is in proper condition. Otherwise, the bulb or the battery has to be changed. Now let us go over to our topic, that is, do liquids conduct electricity? Let us continue. Now, suppose we are doing that with an activity. You are taking a plastic container. In that, you are taking some lemon juice or vinegar. And as you can see, you are connecting it with the help of battery, wires, and bulb. Two rods are dipped into the plastic container, which is having a distance of about 1 centimeter between the rods. There is a distance of 1 centimeter between the rods. Now, when electricity is passed through, that means when current is passing through the wires, what will you see? The bulb glows. Yes? So when the bulb starts glowing, we understand that the electric current is passing through the wires. That means the liquid is conducting electricity. But if the bulb does not glow, let us think of another option. When the bulb does not glow, what does that mean? As I told you that the wires are not in the proper order, or maybe the liquid is not a good conductor. But in this case, we are seeing in this activity that the bulb is glowing because the current is passing through the wires and the bulb starts glowing. So what can we conclude? We can conclude that the liquid is a good conductor. But if weak current is passing through, that means if the current is not strong enough, then what will happen? The bulb will not glow. Electric bulb will not glow, but LED bulbs glow. LED bulbs can run even with weak current, and they can detect very weak currents also. That is why we use the LED bulbs for our experiments. Okay, now as you can see on the screen, there is a picture of a cell where the longer lead and the shorter leads are shown to you. That is just for your information.